remember a while back I mentioned that I don't do shmups much. Another genre that I haven't done an episode on is the old light gun shooters. You know, the games where you take a fake gun and you shoot stuff? Yeah, I haven't done a single one of those, mainly because emulation on those is a little fidgety. Especially since it usually revolves around you emulating the gun with a mouse. Also, I couldn't figure a way to get rid of the second player crosshair. There's not even any credits for that player! Why is that showing? Regardless, today we talk about what is, in my opinion, the most unique entry into the light gun shooter genre. Point Blank. Point Blank was brought to us by Namco, you know, the makers of Pac-Man, Mappy, and Tekken, just to name a few. Point Blank differentiates itself from other light gun shooters by not revolving itself around shooting other humans or monsters, but instead providing a variety of gun-related mini-games. When you start the game, you're given a choice of difficulty, and from there you're given the ability to choose 4 different mini-games. Once you've completed those, you're given 4 more until you've done like 16 mini-games. Unless you're a complete wuss and picked training, that is. And while you only play 16 mini-games in a playthrough, the game itself has 32 different mini-games that it randomly chooses, each with a special hard version too. So due to the random selection, it allows each playthrough of the game to feel very different and adds to the fun. The variety of creative mini-games are definitely the highlight of this game, and they all give you a short explanation of what to do before hitting a timer that you have to complete them by, making this kind of like a weird light gun version of WarioWare. Though it is worth mentioning that this game completely predates the WarioWare series. So let's take a moment to look at the variety of mini-games that are included in Point Blank. You have target shooting, quite a variety of target shooting, I might add. You have shooting an apple off the head of Bootleg Ernie. Look at that face he makes before he registers that you've succeeded. It was like he was completely contemplating his life choices in that moment. Also, kids, don't try that at home, or I'll totally William Tell on you. Shooting a bunch of cardboard criminals. Also, on these levels, you gotta be careful to not shoot any of the hostages. And I especially love how this criminal is hiding in front of the hostage. Good job there. Shooting up someone's liquor cabinet. This brings new meaning to alcohol abuse. Shooting a UFO with a single bullet. Single-handedly taking out a battalion of tanks. Which just poses one question for me. What caliber is this gun we're using? Either it's amazingly powerful to take these tanks out, or these are the absolute shittiest tanks ever made. Shooting skeletons in a graveyard. But be careful though, they might have a bone to pick with you. Because they won't find you shooting them very humorous. So be quick, or they might make a marrow escape. One where you have to shoot buzzards to land a bunch of bootleg Berts and Ernies into a rescue raft. A matching game where you have to shoot the same animal that appears in the display screen. And considering the faces on some of these animals, this might be a mercy killing. Forgive me, Derp Rabbit. You were not meant for this world. I'm sorry. Or one where you have to take on a giant dragon that can only be damaged by shooting its head.
Welcome to the Fantasy Zone. Get ready!
And that's just naming a few of the variety of minigames in this game. Hell, even when you're finished playing the game, you get to put your initials in by shooting the letters on a giant keyboard. And if this game looks fun with one player, it's even more fun with two players. That's right, if a second player puts in a coin, you can then compete with each other in each of these minigames. Point Blank had quite the cult following in the late 90s, as I recall seeing it in a variety of arcades back in the day. It got multiple sequels within its lifespan, with even a fairly recent one coming out in 2016. There was also a Korean ripoff called Zero Point that I remembered seeing in quite a few arcades as well. But we'll leave talking about that game for a future episode. As for Point Blank, I think it's by far the most creative game to ever use a light gun. Maybe even one of the best. So I give it 4 gun cons out of 5. What else can I say? If you haven't played Point Blank, it's definitely worth a shot.